Hello everyone, welcome to the first video in the series Excel Case Study. Today I am going to introduce you the application of the array formula in one of the case which I come across during my FAFD course with ICAI. The case involved relative size factor theory. All of you must be aware that relative size factor theory is to identify anomalies where the largest amount for subsets in a given key is outside the norm for those subsets. This test compares the top two amounts for each subset and calculates the RSF for each. Now let us review our data and let us build the advanced array formula step by step to arrive at the relative size factor in the most effective way. So we have simple data of invoices with vendor number, and invoice amount. And if we have to get the relative size factor of this entire data, it is simply arrived with the large formula. So let me calculate RSF for this entire data. So we want largest and second largest value from the invoice amount column. That can be arrived with the help of large function like this. So I'll go to formula menu, click insert function and search for large. So what large formula requires is an array from which you want to identify the largest value. So in our case, the array is the invoice amounts. So I have selected those invoice amounts. And for K, I am putting 1 because I want the largest value from this array. So this, we have arrived at the largest value from this column. And if I have to find the second largest, I will copy this formula and just modify 1 to 2 so that I have that second largest value from that column. And relative size factor is simply largest value divided by second largest value. So it's 1.1 in our data set. But the real problem is we want the largest value and second largest value for each vendors individually. And we don't have separate data set already there in this file for each vendor, which we can refer to as an array in our large formula. But let's do create a separate data set for a single vendor to understand the first part of the array formula I want you to teach today. So it will be easy to understand the concept when we write the final formula. So for example, if I have to create subset of data from the original data of this column for the first vendor, that is V4437. I will write a formula with if function like this is equal to if open bracket. For logical test, I will select entire vendor data in column A. So I am writing my logical test and I am selecting the vendor numbers and freeze the range reference with F4. So when my vendor numbers equals to V4437, I will freeze V4437 as well. If this logical test is true, then I want the corresponding value in column C. So I will select the data in column C and freeze the range for it also and close bracket. So whenever in this row we have V4437 as vendor, the invoice amount will be written and otherwise it will be a false. So let us copy this formula to the entire rows. Okay, so what we have arrived is For every V4437 invoice, we have derived an array with the invoice amount. So what we have achieved here is we have created a subset of data for a particular vendor V4437. And now I can find the largest and second largest value for this vendor from this easily for vendor V4437. But there is a problem in this method. We have many vendors. And to create the individual subset of data for each vendor like this is a huge task and very ineffective too. So array formula comes in our rescue here. What array formula do for this particular case is to create a virtual data set within the formula for us. So let's start writing the formula. Don't worry, it's nothing but the combination of the two formula we just seen, that is large and if formula, plus some things to remember for array formula. And before we write the array formula, we need to have a unique list of vendors in this data set. So from this data set, I have to derive the unique vendors. So what I will do is I will copy this entire column A, insert a new sheet, paste the data over here, go to data and remove duplicates. So I will remove duplicates from here. Only 181 unique values remain. So I have arrived at the vendor number, unique vendor numbers, and we want to find largest value and second largest value for each vendor individually. And then of course the RSF. That's simple. So let's start writing the array formula. So I will write is equal to large, open bracket. So for array, rather than referencing it to the direct entire array, we will write the conditional formatting with if we just written for vendor V4437. So that is if, open bracket. For logical test, I will select the data in column A for vendors, freeze those range. And what I have to test is this range equals my vendor, first vendor, comma. If the value for this logical test is true, I want to derive the corresponding value from invoice amount. I will freeze the range for this also. Close bracket. And I want the largest value from this subset we just created within the formula, and close bracket. Now most important thing, never press enter for array formula after completing the formula. Always press Ctrl Shift Enter. That is why it is also called CSE formula. What it does is, it first tests the range for the conditions we defined to create the range subset for this cell, just like we did for vendor V4437 in previous step. And second, it checks the value to be the largest or not. So it involves multiple calculations instead of simple formula. And one more thing to note down, you will see curly brackets like this before and after the formula to notify that it's an array formula. So anytime in future you see these curly brackets and you need to modify the formula, after modifying the formula, don't manually write the curly brackets in front of and at the end of the formula. It's not like that. You have to press Ctrl Shift Enter. Like this. The other point to remember is never copy paste an array formula. Always drag it. Or press F2 and copy the cell formula. And we will paste it in the next cell and change the value for K to 2. And again press Ctrl Shift Enter. So we have arrived at the largest value and second largest value for each vendors individually here, very effective way with the array formula. So now let's verify if it is true or not. So I will go to the previous step, filter this entire data, filter it with V4437, our first vendor. And let's see what's the largest value for it. So largest value is 331274. So we have arrived at 331274, and the second largest is 200831. So we can see that also 200831. So our formula calculates the results very correctly. Whenever you see this error, it's because there might be only one data for this vendor. So let's check that. You see that there is only one data, so Excel can't find the second largest value. So it's showing us the error. So that is all about one of the array formula application I wanted to show you. There are many usage of array formula in various scenarios. And you can become a real power user of Excel if you start using array formula. So let's now define array formula as you know one practical application of the same. An array formula performs an operations on multiple values instead of single value. The result of this operation is an array of results, sometimes called a resultant array, because array operations often appear inside other larger formulas. The final result of an array formula can be either one item or an array of items. The only disadvantage of array formula is it can slow down the calculation if your processing speed and memory is down and you have written a huge array formula. So this was CA Dhaval Pawan making you understand that if you are doing a task more than once, you are doing it in a wrong way. Thank you.